Now, in thin film solar cells, there are two different configuration of making these devices, and I want to illustrate them to essentially show you how the TCO is used in these thin film solar cells, where it's located, and what are some of the requirements based upon what kind of cell configuration you are using. So one of the cell configuration for making these thin film solar cell is called as the superstrate type configuration. And this involves essentially starting with a layer of glass, and your cell is essentially made on top of this piece of glass. And then the light on this cell is essentially incident, it's incident from the top of the glass, or in this picture is essentially incident from the bottom of the cell. So this superstrate kind of cell design, where you first start with glass and then deposit all the layers on top of it, it's very commonly used for these amorphous silicon, or this amorphous silicon nanocrystalline silicon tandem cell. It's also used for these cadmium telluride based solar cells, such as the one which are sold by First Solar. So one of the first places you use TCO is to essentially enable this transparent contact. So one of the first layers you deposit in this super straight configuration is this TCO material. And the functionality that it enables is that it enables this transparent electrode, which is transparent to the solar spectrum. In particular, for these super straight configuration, two unique properties that this TCO material needs to have is that it needs to be thermally stable, because most of these other layers, which are the absorber layer and the reflector, the metal reflector layer, are deposited at after this TCO layer has been deposited. So for this superstrate configuration, it needs to have high thermal stability. And that is one of the reasons why people use this fluorine-based tin oxide, because it has a relatively higher thermal stability. For this cadmium telluride, sometimes people also use this cadmium stannate. Typically, people refrain from using cadmium-based TCO material, because cadmium tends to be poisonous. But since over here you are already using cadmium in the CadTel cell, you can use this cadmium stannate, and it's proper very popularly prop popularly used for these CadTel-based solar cell. The other cell configuration is this substrate kind of cell configuration. So in this kind of cell configuration, you first deposit the substrate. So for example, this substrate-based cell, they are often used for making this CIGS-based solar cell. So you start with these flexible substrates, such as could be aluminum or some other substrate, and then you deposit your back metal first, and then you deposit your absorber material, and then towards the end, you deposit this TCO material. So the requirement on thermal stability of this TCO material in this case is not as severe. I'm showing over here this head design, which is a crystalline silicon-based solar cell. But the contact over here are made of this amorphous material. And since the resistivity of this amorphous silicon material is low, usually people use a TCO material on top of this amorphous silicon to essentially enable contact, which is again transparent, at the same time has low resistivity. So this TCO material is used on both the front and back of this head design as well. So some of the functionality that this this TCO material has to enable is essentially it has to form this transparent electrode, which I already mentioned is quite difficult because usually you want high transparency and high conductivity, which are difficult to achieve at the same time. The other functionality that this TCO material often enables is that it acts as an anti-reflective coating, or essentially acts as an index matching layer between your glass in the superstrate configuration, or your air in the substrate configuration. So you know your glass typically has a low refractive index of anywhere between 1.1 to 1.5, and your semiconductor material, it has a much higher refractive index, you know, anywhere between 3 to 4. So this glass, this TCO material, it essentially acts as an anti-reflective coating by essentially enabling or having a refractive index which is a mean of these two refractive index. In this case, a mean of the refractive index between glass and your absorber material. And in the substrate configuration, if you're exposing this directly to air, then the refractive index of this TCO material has to be a mean of the refractive index of air, which is 1, and the refractive index of my absorber material, which is high. So it also performs this function of index matching. Another very important function it performs, so you can see that this TCO material is quite useful. So another function that it performs, that many times people use this TCO material to enable light trapping. So when we talk when we talked about light trapping for a crystalline silicon based cell, you usually achieve that by essentially texturing your silicon. So you have a wafer of silicon and you texture it typically to form these pyramids, which help in randomizing the light and maximizing your trapping of light. But in these thin film based solar cell, one does not have the option of essentially texturing your substrate, because your absorber material itself is so thin that if you want to form these pyramids, which are typically in hundreds of micron kind of a range, there's not enough material to enable this kind of a texturing scheme. So many times what people do is that they texture this TCO material. So they randomly texture this TCO material, which is deposited on top or below your cell. So you enable this very fine texture on this TCO material, and that again helps in randomizing the incoming light and maximizing your light trapping. So we'll talk about how to optimize this TCO material and some of these other features in the next video. So see you in the next video.